Plotinus, substance theory. Plotinus taught there is a supreme, totally transcendent one containing no division, multiplicity, or distinction beyond all categories of being and non-being. His one cannot be any existing thing, nor it is merely the sum of all things, but is prior to all existence. Plotinus identified his one with the concept of good and the principle of beauty. His one concept encompassed thinker and object, even the self-contemplating intelligence, the noesis of the Nous, must contain duality. Once you have uttered the good, add no further thought by any addition, proportion to that addition, you introduce a deficiency. Plotinus denies sentience, self-awareness, or any other action ergon to the one. Rather, if we insist on describing further, we must call the one a sheer potentiality, dynamis, without which any nothing could exist. As Plotinus explains in both places elsewhere, it is impossible for the one to be being or self-aware creator god. Plotinus compared the one to light, the divine intellect, Nous, first will towards good, to the sun, and lastly the soul, Psyche, to the moon, whose light is merely a derivation, conglomeration of the light from the sun. The first light could exist without any celestial body. The one being all attributes, including being and non-being, is the source of the world, but not through any action of creation, willful or otherwise, since activity cannot be ascribed to the unchangeable, immutable one. Plotinus argues, instead of the multiple cannot exist without the simple, the less perfect must of necessity emanate or issue forth from the perfect or more perfect, thus all creation emanates from the one in succeeding stages of lesser and lesser perfection. These stages are not temporarily isolated, but occur throughout time as a constant process. The one is not an intellectual concept, but something that can be experienced, an experience where one goes beyond all multiplicity. Plotinus writes, we ought not even to say that he will, but he will be that which he sees, if indeed it is possible any longer to distinguish between seer and seen, and not boldly to affirm that the two are one. Absolute transcendence of the one or of the divine, as the source of being of all things that yet remains transcendent of them in its own nature, the one is in no way affected or diminished by these emanations, likens the one to the sun, which emanates light indiscriminately without thereby diminishing itself, or reflection in a mirror, which in no way diminishes or otherwise alters the object being reflected. The first emanation is noos, divine mind, logos, order, thought, reason, identified metaphorically with the demiurge in Plato's Timaeus. It is the first will towards good. From noos proceeds the world soul, which Plotinus subdivides into an upper and lower, identifying the lower aspect of the soul with nature. From the world soul proceeds individual human souls, and finally matter, at the lowest level of being, and thus the least perfected level of the cosmos. Plotinus asserted that the ultimately divine nature of material creation, since it ultimately derives from the one, through the mediums of Nous and the world soul, it is by the good or through beauty that we recognize the one in material things and then in the forms. Human happiness, for Plotinus, consists of true human identifying with that which is the best in the universe. Eudaimonia, happiness, is attainable only within consciousness.